I think everybody knows somebody that maybe have been touched by cancer in some form or another. There's so many things that cancer can take you through, and I think as a world, we need to be conscious that it does affect all of us.
I'm Martin Townsend. I'm 34 years old from Birmingham, Alabama. I'm a young adult cancer survivor.
I'm Verry G. Townsend, and I'm Martin's mother.
Spring break of my sophomore year of college, that I noted that I wasn't really feeling quite right. I eventually went to the Student Health Center, and one thing led to another where they could see in my blood counts that something wasn't altogether normal. After taking some initial blood tests at Druid City Hospital in Tuscaloosa, I had received a diagnosis of leukemic blasts in my peripheral blood. It was unique in that it was by phenotypic acute leukemia.
I think the words from his mouth was, "Mom, I have cancer." It hit me, but immediately, I guess you go into kind of like mama bear mode, and it's like, okay, I gotta be strong for him. At that time, they said, we need to begin chemotherapy immediately. They told us that it was an aggressive type of leukemia, that if we did not start treatment, that Martin could literally be dead in 3 weeks. Martin was in the hospital approximately 40 days during that induction chemotherapy. I think it was about day 39 that he was in remission. Because the type of leukemia had a high return rate, he had to stay on chemotherapy for 3.5 years. It was March of 2015 when we got the news that it had reoccurred.
That's the last thing you want to hear, that your cancer has come back. My doctor reassured me at the time that there was an option that she wanted me to try that was an immunotherapy. You don't know what to expect, but it became like a full-time job.
The regimen was really about 4 days a week. Blincyto was our last chance. He had to tolerate it. If Blincyto didn't work, he would die. You know, but Blincyto had to work. In the meanwhile, they had talked to his father and I to let us know that we needed to get tested because they were going to have to do the bone marrow transplant after he got back in remission. They decided that his father was the better match.
In finishing up my immunotherapies with a positive outcome of being in remission, I guess stem cell transplant was in July, like towards the end of July. From a health standpoint, there's been no cancer-related events. I see my doctors now about once a year. The visits are fairly boring, which you want visits to not be exciting. Being in remission, that's the biggest thing. For advocates out there, keep telling your stories. We all have to face those same, you know, perspectives in life that may wake us up to something that is a critical health experience, and that's not gonna care who you are. Funding for cancer research is really centrally integral to why I'm still here. You're saving people's lives.
We would ask our Congress, our legislatures to continue to fund research, continue to fund the NIH, because it's needed.